वेलकम टू फार्माटून जीपैट नाइपर जी चैनल। कृपया मेरी इस चैनल को आप सब्सक्राइब करो, लाइक करो एंड शेयर करो। एंड यस, डोंट फॉरगेट टू क्लिक ऑन द बेल आइकॉन ताकि जब भी मैं नया वीडियो अपलोड करूं आपको सूचित किया जा सके। थैंक यू। वेलकम टू माय चैनल फार्माटून्स, अ कंप्लीट जीपैट नाइपर जी सॉल्यूशन। दोस्तों, आज का हमारा टॉपिक है रिएक्शन ऑफ फैट एंड ऑयल्स। तो आइए देखते हैं फर्स्ट रिएक्शन, दैट इज़ ए हाइड्रोलिसिस काइंड ऑफ रिएक्शन। सो एज वी ऑल नो दैट फैट्स आर जनरली हाइड्रोलाइज बाय द एंजाइम लाइपेज टू यील्ड ए फैटी एसिड्स एंड ग्लिसरॉल। सो फैट्स आर जनरली इन ईस्टर फॉर्म अपॉन हाइड्रोलाइसिस बाय लाइपेज एंजाइम विच इज़ कन्वर्टेड इन टू द फैटी एसिड एज वेल एज द ग्लिसरॉल। फैटी एसिड इज नथिंग बट एसिडिक कंपाउंड, ग्लिसरॉल इज नथिंग बट ट्राईहाइड्रिक अल्कोहल। सो बेसिकली द लाइपेज कैटालाइज दिस काइंड ऑफ रिएक्शन एट स्लाइटली एसिडिक पीएच, दैट मीन्स 7.5 to 8.5 इन ए स्टेप वाइज मैनर। इनिशियली लाइपेज दैट प्रोड्यूस द डाई ग्लिसराइड, दैट मीन्स वन ईस्टर ग्रुप दैट इज हाइड्रोलाइज टू alcoholic group as well as the fatty acid, then it is converted into the monoglycerides and finally it is converted into the fatty acid and glycerol. So this is a triglyceride. So all three are the ester group. So first third ester group in presence of water and lipase enzyme which is converted into the diglyceride as well as the fatty acids. Again this diglyceride, second ester group in presence of water and lipase which is converted into the monoglyceride and fatty acid, and same way monoglyceride hydrolyzed to glycerol, that is nothing but trihydroxy alcohol and fatty acid. So this is a hydrolysis of fat. Now next is a saponification process. So what is saponification? So hydrolysis of fat by the alkali, here we are using NaOH or KOH as a alkali. So the process is called saponification, and the reaction result in the formation of the glycerol and salt of fatty acids which are also called the SOPs. So in saponification what happened? So by using alkali which is converted into the glycerol as well as the salt of the fatty acids. So let us take an example. This is a triolein kind of the fats. NaOH which is act as a alkali, so under saponification process which is converted into the glycerol as well as the sodium salt of the oleic acid, that is called sodium oleate SOP. So sodium salt of fatty acid which is considered as a SOP, and the process is called the saponification. Next is a hydrolytic rancidity. So rancidity is nothing but deterioration of the fats as well as the oil. So when any butter or any fats are stored and they often become rancid, hence unpalatable. So why such kind of fats and oils are become rancid? This is only because of the auto oxidations, because fats and oils are containing the number of the double bond, and these number of double bond are more prone to oxidation and hence it is deteriorated. So basically it is caused by the growth of the microorganism when which secrete the enzyme lipases, and as we know that lipase is a hydrolytic enzyme which is convert fat into the fatty acid as well as the glycerol. So this lipase enzyme split the fat into the glycerol and free fatty acids, and this fatty acid impart the unpleasant odor as well as the flavor to the fat. Butter may be prevented from becoming a rancid by refrigerations or exclusion of the water. So by these way we can prevent the fat as well as the oil by keeping it in proper storage condition. Next is a hydrogenation. So first let us clear what is a hydrogenation. So hydrogenation means addition of the hydrogen to double bond. Okay. So hydrogenation process is generally used to convert alkene to alkane. So alkene is nothing but unsaturated fatty acids, either free or in combined lipid form, react with gaseous hydrogen to yield a saturated fatty acid. So as I said that unsaturated fatty acid, so alkene groups is present, and after hydrogenation which is converted into the saturated fatty acid which is called alkanes. That means C double bond C that is converted into the C single bond C that is alkane, and the reaction is generally catalyzed by three catalysts, platinum, palladium and nickel, which is called heterogeneous catalyst. Addition of the hydrogen takes place at the carbon-carbon double bonds. One mole of oleic, linoleic and linolenic acid react with 1, 2 and 3 mole of the hydrogen respectively to form a stearic acid. So why it happened? Because of oleic acid has a 1 double bond, linoleic acid having a 2 double bond and linolenic acid having a 3 double bond. So for reducing 1 double bond, 1 mole of hydrogen is required. Linoleic acid having a 2 double bond, hence 2 mole of hydrogens are required. Linolenic acid having a 3 double bond, hence 3 mole of the hydrogen is required. So this is a one of the example where in 9 and 10 position there is a double bond. In presence of the gaseous hydrogens, platinum, palladium and nickel that is act as a catalysis, and the whole process is known as a heterogeneous catalysis process which is converted into the stearic acid. So here there is a double bond and here there is a single bond. So double bond is reduced by the hydrogenation process. Next is a halogenation. So it is the same kinds of reaction where on carbon-carbon double bond that is present in the fat which is halogenated by addition kinds of reactions. So unsaturated fatty acid and ester can take up the halogen like bromine at their double bonds at room temperature in acetic acid as well as the methanolic solution. This is a one of the example. Linoleic acid where 9 and 10 position there is a double bond and 12 and 30 position there is a double bond in presence of iodine. So for 1 double bond 1 mole of iodine required, 2 double bond 2 mole of iodine is required at room temperature, that gives a addition kinds of reaction at 9 and 10 and 12 and 13 position, and these reaction is a basis of iodine number determination by the Hannus method where IBR is a reagent or which is called Hannus reagent used to determine iodine number practically. Next is oxidation. So oxidations of the fat generally carried out by two methods. One is ozone and another is chaminophore. Let us discuss the oxidation by the ozone method. So free fatty acids having a various double bonds are present, and through ozonolysis in presence of O3 which is converted into the ozonide, and through oxidative hydrolysis which is converted into the aldehyde group, and this aldehyde group having a unpleasant odor. Next is oxidation by chaminophore. So under mild condition, whatever double bond present in the fat which is converted into the glycol, or we can say diol, these are the form at the site of the double bond. So it is nothing but kinds of Bayer reactions or Bayer reagents where chaminophore is used. So at 9 and 10 position there is a double bond. So in presence of chaminophore which is converted into the diol, or we can say glycol, because at 9 and 10 position there is a hydroxy group is attached. Next is oxidative rancidity. So generally oil containing a high unsaturated fatty acid, and as I said that with atmospheric oxygen it is spontaneously oxidized at ordinary temperature, and the oxidation takes place slowly and result in the formation of the short chain fatty acids, say for example C4 to C10 as well as the aldehyde, which is responsible for rancid taste as well as the odor to our fat. And these type of rancidity or rancidification is called oxidative rancidity and is due to the reaction is called auto oxidation, and generally it is proceed by free radical mechanism where three steps are involved: chain initiation, chain propagation and chain terminations. All steps are not mentioned here, but let us see the example. This is a free radical of any fats and oil, and where in presence of atmospheric oxygen, which is converted at peroxy radical. Peroxy radical again react with the new fatty acids, so that is converted into the hydroperoxide. So whatever radical is present at here, again that is react with new fatty acid, which is converted into the hydroperoxides, and again free radical is generated. Okay, so this is a concept of oxidative rancidity. Oxidative rancidity is observed more frequently in animal fat compared to vegetable fat. It is not observed in vegetable fat because of in vegetable fat many times natural antioxidants are present, such as tocopherols, which is also called vitamin E, some phenols as well as the naphthols. Therefore, vitamin E sometimes added to food to prevent the rancidity, and some synthetic antioxidants are also used, which are nor-dihydroguaretic acid, NDGA, tertiary butyl hydroxyanisole, BHA, as well as the tertiary butyl hydroxy toluene. These all are the synthetic antioxidants. And last is a dehydration test, which is also called acrolein test. So acrolein test is generally used to identify glycerol in the fat. Now let us discuss what is dehydration. Dehydration meaning is removal of the water from the sample. So for that, various dehydrating agents like sodium hydrogen sulfate and potassium hydrogen sulfates are used that produce an unsaturated aldehyde called acrolein. So acrolein, chemically it is a unsaturated aldehyde where vinyl group is directly attached with the aldehyde group from the glycerol moiety. Acrolein is easily recognized by its pungent odor and thus form the basis of the taste for the presence of glycerol in fat molecule. So it is the acrolein test, it is generally for to check the presence of glycerol in fat molecule. So how the reaction is occurred? So glycerol, by using sodium hydrogen sulfate, so it will remove the water molecule from these three hydroxy group, and ultimately which is converted into the acrolein. So as I said, that acrolein is nothing but unsaturated aldehyde. Unsaturated means carbon-carbon double bond, which is directly attached with the aldehyde group by loss of the 2 mole of the water in presence of sodium hydrogen sulfate as well as the potassium hydrogen sulfate, which is act as a dehydrating agent. So this is all about reactions of the fats and oil. So thank you for watching my channel. Please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you.